side crates. Probe one is on the discharge capacitor between the two coils. And the blue trace is on the drain of the MOSFET switching. Light coil. You can see there exactly what's happening with the inductor discharge, the way the circuit is configured. Pretty neat. Inductive discharge through this battery there as well. And connected to the capacitor positive. So while I stop there like that, I'm going to switch the power off. See what happens. Power to the coils is switched off, but the MOSFET is still switching. Interesting. Let's see the yellow drivers. That's the capacitor voltage. That is right there. The little capacitor there. This coil is the charging coil for the charging circuit. It discharges into that capacitor and react at 23 volts and 12 volts at that peak with the drive and main drive coil. Frequency is 978 volts. This is the optical that is mounted on this bar, which can swing either way. Adjust the timing. I'm not sure exactly what angle that coil's at, but it's a little bit less than 45 degrees. This is charge battery. Charge on. This is input current. Just under 700 milliamps, between 600 and 700 milliamps. What happens is the sensor reads the silver strips on the rotor, and no matter what size the signal the photo reflective transistor puts out, I can adjust the sensitivity with this, and then this little transistor switches from the rail and the CD4011 chip. Then outputs a logic level output, 5-volt pulse, rectangular pulse. It then comes into this circuit, and this circuit then you can use to vary that signal pulse into whatever size pulse you want. And that varies pulses to pop. These two end switches are for the description capacitors. Very frequency here, which is for the re-triggering of the evening. I can switch here between an inverted and non-inverted signal from the CD 4011 chip. Okay, so it's down at 78 Hz. I'm using that much current for a 12-volt battery. Almost 700 milliamps. Now I'll go ahead and I'll remove this coil right out of the way. Back over there, out of the way. You can hear the rotor slow down. This reverses the voltage and the capacitor rises to 26 volts. Slide this coil back into position. Just under 600 million at 60 Hz. That's the basic input, and that's creating a charge output as well to the battery. So, using the plastic coil. Right. moving the center to the left. Branch is responding to the charges. Power speed is there with pressure to the top. And to the pole top. Pressure to the dead turn and magnetize it. Cool. Things of steel. This is in my parts of the rotor.
That's about it. What? That's the, that's out.